rejoice and be glad, O Virgin Mary. Alleluia. For the Lord is risen indeed. Alleluia. Let us pray. O God, who through the resurrection of thy Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, didst vouchsafe to give joy to the whole world, grant, we beseech thee, that through his mother, the Virgin Mary, we may obtain the joys of everlasting life, through the same Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. In nomine Patris et Filii et Spiritus Sancti. Amen. In tuoi volontari Dei, et angeli, ti figari iugum tutum eum. Iuricam et esse vicino a casa meum de gente non sancta, aber homine ne condolo sorro a me. Quae tu, Seus, multibus lumae, quare ne crisis, quare crisis in cielo, ne flici meritus. E me delugem dura meritatem tu, mis ne dulce, non tu dulce, non ti montum sanctum tuam, et tabernacula tua. Et in tuoi volontari Dei, et angeli, ti figari iugum tutum eum. Confidebo di vincitra, Deus, Deus meus, quae tristis anima mea, quare contubas me. Sperem Deo, conem et confidebo iri, salutare vultus me, et Deus meus. Gloria, Patri, et Filio, et Spiritui Sancto, sicut erat in principio, et nunc et semper, et in saecula saeculorum. Amen. In tuoi volontari Dei, et angeli, ti figari iugum totum meum. Auri Domini nostrum in nomine Domini, qui feci caelum et terra. Confiti, o Domini potenti, beate Maria, sem Virgine, beate Michaelet, Angelo, beate Guardi Battista, i Sanctis Vostris Petrus, Pavlo, beate Ione, Maria, Viagna, un plus Sanctis Vobis Frates, qui ebo Domini, mis cogitazione, per voi, d'offrone, meo culpa, mea maxima culpa. Ed io prego, beate Maria, sem Virgine, beate Michaelet, Angelo, beate Guardi Battista, un Sanctus Vostris Petrus, Pavlo, beate Guardi Maria, Viagna, un Sanctus Vostris Frates, orrore come il Domini, ben nostro. Miseria a tutti, unipotenza, e se tu mi spiegati, tu mi spiegati a te, vita me te. Amen. Confiti, o Deo, omnipotenti, beate Maria, sempre Virgini, beate Decali, Arcangelo, beato Ioanni Battiste, Santis Apostolis, Petro et Paolo, omnibus Santis, et Divi Pate, qui ab caminimis cogitazione, verbo et opere, meo culpa, meo culpa, mea maxima culpa. Ed io prego, beata Maria, sed Virginem, beata Michaelum Arcangelum, beata Ioannem Battistam, Sanctus Apostolos Petrum et Paulum, omnes Sanctos et Te Pater, orare pro me, ad Dominum Deum nostrum. Miseriatum vesti, nipotens Deus, et mis peccatis vestris, peducat vos et vitam aeternam. Amen. Et uge nisim assusionem et remissionem, et gudor nostrum, et vivat nomis omnipotens et misericordiornos. Amen. Deus te conversus vivificabis nas, et plex tu eleita abitor in te, os et in nobis Domini misericordiam tua, et salutare tua dai nobis, Domine exaudi l'actione mea, et clamo meus et te veniat, Dominus obiscum, et cum spirito tuo, orre. Aqua sapiens et potavit eos, alleluia, firmabitur in iris et non flectetur, alleluia. Ut et exultavit eos in eternum, alleluia, alleluia. Confitemini Domino et invocati nomen eus, annunciante ente gentes opere eus. Gloria Patri et Filio et Spiritui Sancto, sic erat in principio et nunc et semper, et in saecula saeculorum, amen. Aqua sapiens et potavit eos, alleluia. Firmabitur in hilis et non flectetur, alleluia. Et exultabit eos in aeternum, alleluia, alleluia. Kyrie eleison, Kyrie eleison, Kyrie eleison, Christe eleison, Christe eleison, Christe eleison, Kyrie eleison, Kyrie eleison, Kyrie eleison. Gloria in excelsis Deo, et in terra pax hominibus bone voluntatis, laudamus te, benedicimus te, adoramus te, glorificamus te, gratias agimus tibi propter magnam gloriam tuam. Domine Deus rex celestis, Deus Pater omnipotens, Domine Filii unigenite, Iesu Christe, Domine Deus omnibus Dei, Filius Patris, qui tollis peccato mundi miserere nobis, qui tollis peccato mundi, suscipe et deprecatione nostra. Qui senset exeram Patris, miserere nobis. Gloriam tu solus Sanctus, tu solus Dominus, tu solus Altissimus, Iesu Christe, cum Sancto Spiritu in gloria Dei Patris. Amen. ex vobis, et cum spirito tuo. Oremus. Legus qui ecclesiam tuam nove semper fetum multiplicas, concede familis tuis, ut sacramentum vivendo teniant quod fide perceperunt, per Dominum nostrum Iesum Christum filium tuum, qui tecum vivit regnat in aeternitate Spiritus Sancti Deus, per omnia saecula saeculorum. Amen. Lectio actuum apostolorum. In diebus illis suscens Paulus et Manius Silentium indicenseit, viri fratres, filii generis Abraham, et qui in vobis timen Deum, vobis verum salutis huius missum est, qui enim habitamant in Jerusalem, et principes eius ignorantes Iesum, et voces prophetarum, quae per omne sabbatum leguntur judicantes in pleverum, et multum tausum mortis invenientes in Deo pietierunt a Pilato ut interfecerent Deum. Cum summamassent omnia quae de eius scripta erant, deponentes eum de nigno possuerunt Deum in monumento. Deus vero suscitavit Deum a mortuis die tertiae die, qui visus est per Deus multus his qui simul ascendarent cum eo de Galilaea in Jerusalem, qui usque nunc sunt est eius et plebe. Et nos vobis annunciamus eam, quae patris nostros repromissio facere est, quonim hanc Deus ad implevit filiis hoc nostris, resuscitans Iesum Christum Dominum nostrum.
Deo gratias.
Et dies quam feci Dominus, exultemus et laetemur in ea, dicantunque redensi sunt ad Domino, quos redemus de manu inimici, et de regionibus congregavi Deus. Alleluia, alleluia! Surrexit Dominus de sepulcro, qui pro nobis perpendit indigno.
Vigile Paschali laudes, immolent Christiani, alius retenit ove, innocens patri reconciliavi peccatores. Mors et vita duello confixere mirando lux vitae vultus regnat vivus. In nobis Maria
Santi Evangelii secundum Luca.
Gloria a tibi, Domine.
In ino tempore sedit Iesus in medio discipulorum suorum et dicit eis, pax vobis, ebus sum, non lite timere. Contubati vero e conteliti estimaban se spiritum videre, et dicit eis, qui turbati estit, et cogitationes ascendunt in corda vestra? Videte manus meus et pedes, quae ego ipse sum. Palpite, videte, quae spiritus calum et osse non habet, sicum me videtis habere. Et cum hoc disisit ostendides manus et pedes, ad hoc autem illis non credensibus et mirantibus regaudio dixit, habeti sic aliquid quod manducetur? Et ili objulerunt et patim piscis assi et favum meris, et cum manducasit coram meus sumes reliquias dedit eis. Et dicit ad Deus, hec sunt verba, quae locutus sum ad vos, cum ad hoc esse vobiscum, quodiam necessi est implere omnia, quae scriptas sunt in lege Moisi, et prophetis, et psalmis de me. Tunc aperuit idi sensum, ut intelligerum scripturas, et dixit eis, quoniam sic scriptum est, et sic opotebat Christum pati, et resurgere a mortuis tertia die, et predicare in nomine eius penitentiam, et remissionem peccatorum in nomine gentes. Laus tibi Christi. On this Tuesday in the octave of Pascha, the lesson is taken from the Acts of the Apostles. At this time, Paul stood up and made a gesture with his hand to claim audience. Brethren, he said, you who are sons of Abraham, and you others who fear God, this message of salvation is sent to you. The people at Jerusalem, like their rulers, did not recognize Jesus for what he was. Unwittingly they fulfilled, by condemning him, those utterances of the prophets which they had heard read, Sabbath after Sabbath. And although they could find no capital charge against him, they petitioned Pilate for his death. So when they had fulfilled all that had been written about him, they took him down from the cross and laid him in a tomb. And on the third day God raised him from the dead. He was seen over a space of many days by the men who had come up with him from Galilee to Jerusalem. It is they who now bear witness of him before the people. And this is the message we preach to you. There was a promise made to our forefathers, and this promise God has redeemed for our posterity by raising to life Jesus Christ our Lord. And the Holy Gospel today is the continuation of that according to St. Luke. At this time, Jesus stood in the midst of his disciples and said, "Peace be upon you. It is myself. Do not be afraid." They cowered down, full of terror, thinking that they were seeing an apparition. "What," he said to them, "are you dismayed? Whence come these surmises in your hearts? Look at my hands and my feet, to be assured that it is myself. Touch me and look. A spirit has no flesh and bones as you see that I have." And as he spoke thus, he showed them his hands and his feet. Then, while they were still doubtful and bewildered with joy, he asked them, "Have you anything here to eat?" So they put before him a piece of roast fish and a honeycomb. So he ate in their presence and bade them share his meal. "This is what I told you," he said, "while I still walked in your company. Of all that was written of me in the law of Moses and in the prophets and in the Psalms must be fulfilled." Then he enlightened their minds to make them understand the scriptures. "So it was written," he told them, "and so it was fitting that Christ should suffer and should rise again from the dead on the third day, and that repentance and remission of sins should be preached in his name to all nations." Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners now and at the hour of our death. Amen. In nomine Patris et Filii et Spiritus Sancti. Amen. Carissimi, beloved in Christ, welcome to this broadcast Mass on this Tuesday in the octave of Pascha, known to us, of course, as Easter. But let me just clear up something after a certain tweet, which I think has now become infamous on Twitter, where two fairly significant people, and who really ought to know better, suggested that you and I and our brothers and sisters in Christ who were martyred last Sunday were worshippers of a Germanic pagan goddess known as Istra, because in their tweet they referred to us as Easter worshippers. My brothers and sisters, we are not Easter worshippers. We may worship at Easter, but we do not worship the goddess Istra. Istra, as a term, has become a kind of Anglo-Saxon word because it was brought by the Saxons from Germany when they invaded England way back at the beginning of the so-called Dark Ages. And it was their name for the month of April. And because the Paschal feast generally fell in April, so it was that the term developed and began to be used to refer to Paschal Sunday, to Easter Sunday. But it's quite wrong to suggest that we are Easter worshippers, because the phrase suggests something else. What they meant to say, of course, was how awful it was, these people who were tragically murdered whilst worshipping on Easter Sunday, is how they should have put it. But by using the phrase Easter worshippers, it's almost like a slur on our faith, and particularly because they use Easter worshippers because they wouldn't use the word Christians. And believe it or not, my brothers and sisters, there is a certain sentiment, a certain thinking among certain people that to use the term Christian with regard to the persecution, particularly that we are facing on a daily basis throughout the world, is to somehow to give us more credence or more credibility than perhaps we deserve. Part of this, of course, comes from a relativist perspective, that Christianity should be regarded simply the same as other religions in the world. Now, irrespective of whether that's true or not, what is certainly true is that no other faith, no other religion in the world would be spoken of by these people using a term that was not, using a term that was potentially offensive. And we, my brothers and sisters, as Christians, should not ourselves put up with that kind of nonsense nor that kind of attitude. We really are the most persecuted religion in the world, and pretty much we always have been for our 2018 years of existence. Remember that more Christians died in the 20th century because they were Christians than of the adherents of any other faith in the world. We're talking millions. Millions of Christians were martyred in the 20th century. Not just a few thousand. Millions. And remember those shocking statistics from the beginning of the 21st century. That somewhere in the region, approximately, on average, 125,000 Christians are martyred per month, have been martyred per month since the turn of the 21st century. It's about time, my brothers and sisters, that some of us Christians woke up. It's about time that some of us started speaking up for our brothers and sisters around the world who are facing extreme persecution. Persecution unto death. And there are reports available practically on a daily basis when numbers of brothers and sisters in Christ have been killed simply because they are Christian. I'm sad to note that whereas, for example, after the tragedy in New Zealand or after the tragedy in Pittsburgh last year, there has been a notable absence of outcry from other sections of the community and of the faith community. No one is calling for a vigil in solidarity. question we might ask ourselves is, why is that? Why is nobody calling for a vigil in solidarity for the martyrs of Sri Lanka? Why are other perceived persecuted faiths not offering to stand in solidarity with the martyrs in Sri Lanka? Part of the issue, part of the problem, is because we ourselves, particularly here in the West, we ourselves are silent. We ourselves do not speak up. Many of us indeed are ignorant of the situation of Christians in other places. The vast majority of Christians in this country alone, here in the UK, are ignorant of the number of martyrs who give their lives for Christ every day. Most Christians are ignorant of the statistics concerning the 20th century, let alone the 21st century. More were martyred for Christ in the 20th century than in all the preceding centuries put together. But how many Christians know that? How many Christians speak about that? And how many Christians speak about the persecution endured by brothers and sisters in the faith around the world today? True, we may get the odd word in solidarity from the Archbishop of Canterbury, perhaps, or from the Bishop of Rome, perhaps, or one or two other notable Christians may say something about it, may mention it. But it's interesting that those who are just about given a voice in our secularized world don't harp on, don't keep mentioning it, for fear ultimately that they then themselves will be silenced. And what does that suggest then? It suggests the truth. We are indeed the most persecuted faith in the world. And that persecution includes the silencing of our voices in the public fora around us. There have been and there will be plenty of voices that will speak up and talk about the human tragedy, the human cost. But they will do their level best to avoid attributing our faith to those who died. Even though the vast majority of those slaughtered on Sunday were Christians, even though they were deliberately targeted at their places of worship and during worship times. Those buildings, those churches were targeted, those bombs to go off when the maximum amount of people would be in there worshipping. That is why there are photos where you can see the blood of the martyrs splattered across the walls, across the statues, across a Paschal candle. And just like the awfulness of abortion, Facebook et al. Are trying to limit people's exposure to those images. So that photos of the burial of the children martyred, who on that Sunday were to receive their first Holy Communion, even those photos are not are being censored on social media. You have to click on a thing to agree to say you are happy to see them. They won't just appear in your feed. Just as with the fire at Notre Dame, so many commentators didn't even mention that it was Holy Week, or dismiss the significance that this took place in Holy Week. So many of them couldn't even be bothered to research properly the terms to describe what a cathedral is, what a cathedral means, who the staff are at a cathedral. And the same ignorance was showed again last Sunday and in reports since. But for any other similar tragedy to any other group of people, they would be sure to get their facts right. They would be sure to research the proper titles for the religious leaders and community leaders involved. But when it comes to Christianity, when it comes to the Catholic faith, such courtesy is ignored, is dismissed. We'll just call so-and-so the chief priest, even though there is no such Christian title. And notice, my brothers and sisters, that the solidarity that was expressed concerning Notre Dame had nothing to do with the faith, but was all about the architecture. The building was described as iconic, as a representation of France, of a personalization of the nation, embodied in this historic piece of architecture, this iconic image of Paris. Nothing was said of the faith that had maintained and built that cathedral. Next to nothing was said about the community of faith that worshipped there. To my knowledge, no one has bothered to interview actual worshippers from the cathedral and ask them about their feelings or about what they think should be done to restore it. Instead, a great competition has been launched. A competition that is not limited to Catholics, to French Catholics, not limited even to Christians, but open to all and sundry from all over the world to create a new roof. And we have to ask, will someone who is not of the faith offer something sympathetic? Or indeed, they may offer something vaguely sympathetic to the Gothic architecture, or reflective of the architecture of the environment around the cathedral, perhaps. But will they include crosses? Will they include iconography? Will the roof speak to the faith of the church it is supposed to house? From some of those designs that are already bandying about, I have to say I doubt it. And again, my brothers and sisters, aside from platitude, aside from expressing sentiments, of course, of solidarity with the people of France at the loss of this beautiful iconographic building, so on and so forth, even from our religious leaders, little has been said about the faith, about the nature of the attack, about the timing of the attack. Of the relevance and significance of similar acts of arson in other churches around France, and not just in France, but across Europe. Again, our own Christian leaders are too timid, too afraid to speak to the persecution of the church in our Western societies. We, my brothers and sisters, are called to proclaim and to preach the faith in and out of season, as St. Paul writes to Timothy. How many of our Christian leaders use the opportunity, with what limited voice they have in the public sphere, to speak to the gospel rather than to social attitudes? But how many of us speak about the gospel in our everyday lives? How many of us talk about or share our faith with our non-religious family members and loved ones and friends? How many of us explain the significance of what a cathedral is? How many of us explain the significance of what First Holy Communion meant to those children martyred on Sunday? How many of us have spoken to the importance for Christians of worshipping on Easter Sunday. How many of us didn't even perceive a slight in the term Easter worshipper? My brothers and sisters, the church is facing at this present time the most acute persecution and widespread persecution that she has ever experienced in over 2,000 years. And this persecution that we are experiencing is occurring in different ways. Yes, in extreme violence, such as was seen last Sunday, but also too, more insidiously and more perfidiously, within the secularizing attitudes that are beginning to embed themselves in Christians themselves. And this, my brothers and sisters, is the greatest tragedy. That for all the availability of real knowledge widely available today, of collected wisdom of 2,000 years of Christian theology, scholarship, of devotion, the vast majority of Christians today have no real idea of what it means to be a Christian, have no real idea of who Christ is, let alone who he was. The old heresies from the first millennium are spread abroad today, often by those even who should know better, but so enslaved and entrapped are they to the changing attitudes of the secular world that they cannot recognize anymore, cannot see anymore the truth, even though it may stare at them from the letters of the page, even though they may read and proclaim the truth. Their hearts and their minds no longer understand it. And so it behoves us Orthodox Catholics around the world to make a point ourselves of seeking in charity to correct our brothers and sisters in the faith. That we may stem this heresy which ultimately leads away from God. We should hope, my brothers and sisters, for another generation of apostles like Peter and Paul, these two saints whom we have venerated in this Paschal week, spiritually visiting the tomb of St. Peter yesterday and today St. Paul with the neophytes who were baptized last Saturday. These two great pillars of the church, whom we would do well to emulate. Just as those neophytes sought their intercession, so should we, my brothers and sisters. and continually open our hearts and minds to receive the guidance of the Holy Spirit, that we may know the truth, even if it means being condemned by the truth, by speaking the truth to the world around us. We don't need, my brothers and sisters, a voice in the public forum around us. We need only to use our voices in the spheres of influence that we have, speaking the truth with love to our family, to our friends, to our colleagues, to our communities, to our societies. Only in that wise might we hope. Prevent the tragedies that are going on around us in the world today. Only in that way might we hope to encourage others with the influence and the power to stop the persecution of our brothers and sisters in Christ. Let us, my brothers and sisters, in this great week of Pascha, find the strength and the courage, because of our joy at Jesus' resurrection, to speak the truth with love to whomever we meet, and to whomever especially is most precious to us. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Ghost. Amen. Amen.
I believe in one God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, and of all things visible and invisible, and in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, begotten of his Father before all. God of God, light of light, very God, begotten, not made, being of one substance with the Father, by whom all things were made, who for us men and for our salvation came down from heaven, and was incarnate by the Holy Ghost of the Virgin Mary, and was made man, and was crucified also for us under Pontius Pilate. He suffered and was buried, and the third day he rose again, according to the Scriptures, and ascended into heaven, and sitteth at the right hand of the Father. And he shall come again with glory, to judge both the quick and the dead, whose kingdom shall have no end. And I believe in the Holy Ghost,
by the prophets, and I believe one Catholic and Apostolic Church. I acknowledge one baptism for the remission of sins, and I look for the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen.
Dominus vobiscum, et cum spirito tuo. Orde. Intoniuit de celo Dominus, et altissimus dedit vocem suam, et apparuerunt fontes aquam. Alleluia. Secula seculorum.
Amen.
Dominus vobiscum, et cum spirito tuo, sosum corda, habemus ad Dominum, gratias ad amus Domino Deo nostro, dignum et justum est, veri dignum et justum est ecum salutare, nostibi sempre dubi, veri dignum et justum est ecum salutare, te quidem Domine omni tempore, sed in hoc potissimum de gloriosius predicare, cum Pascha nostrum immolatus est Christus, ipse in veus est agnus qui ansulit peccatum mundi, qui morte nostram moriendo destruxit, et vita resurgendo reperavit, et ideo cum angelis et arcangelis, cum tronis et dominationibus, cumque omnibus celestis exegitus, in un gloria tuae canibus, sine fine dicendes. Sanctus, 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 Dominus Deus sabaoth, plenissimum caeli et terra, gloria tua, hosanna in excelsis. Benedictus qui venit in nomine Domini, hosanna in excelsis. Nomen Quoque peccatoribus.
regnania sicula siculorum.
Amen.
Ordemus precepti salutaribus moliti de vinus luciani formati, ademus dicere. Pater noster qui eis in cieli, sanctificetur nomen tuum, et venia regnum tuum, fiat voluntas tua, sicut in cielo et in terra. Panem nostrum quotidianum da nobis hodie, dimitte nobis debita nostra, sicut nos dimittimus debitoribus nostris, et ne nos inducas in tentatione. Sed libera nos de male. Per omnia saecula saeculorum.
Amen.
Pax Domini sit semper vobis, et cum spiritu tuo. Agnus Dei.
Salus
peccato mundi.
ecce agnus Dei, ecce qui tollit peccato mundi. Domine, non sum dignus ut intre sub tectum meum, sed tantum dic verbo et sendabitur anima mea. Domine, non sum dignus ut intre sub tectum meum, sed tantum dic verbo et sendabitur anima mea. Domine, non sum dignus ut intre sub tectum meum, sed tantum dic verbo et sendabitur anima mea. Brothers and sisters watching Mass online and unable therefore to receive the Blessed Sacrament, we invite you now to make an act of spiritual communion. My Jesus, I believe that thou art present in the Blessed Sacrament. I love thee above all things, and I desire thee in my soul. Since I cannot now receive thee sacramentally, calmly, spiritually into my heart, as though thou wert already there, I embrace thee and unite myself wholly to thee. Permit not that I should ever be separated from thee. Amen. Sicut sur existis cum Christum, quae susum sunt quenite, ubi Christus est in dextra Dei sedens, alleluia. Quae susum sunt sapite, alleluia. Dominus vobiscum, et cum spirito tuo.
Oremus. Concede quaesmus omnibutens Deus, ut Paschalis perceptio sacramenti continua in nostris mentibus persevere. Per Dominum nostrum Iesum Christum filium tuum, vitecum divita regnat in unitate Spiritus Sancti Deus, per omnia saecula saeculorum.
Amen.
Dominus vobiscum, et cum spirito tuo, ite missa est, alleluia, alleluia. Deo gratias, alleluia, alleluia.
Se in nome Domini benedictum ex oblungo tusque in saecula autotorum nostrum in nomine Domini, qui feci caelum et terram, benedicat vos omnipotens Deus.
Pater, et Filius, et Spiritus Sanctus.
Amen.
Dominus vobiscum, et cum spirito tuo, initium Sancti Evangelii secundum Ioannem. Gloria tibi Domine. In principio erat verbum, et verbum erat apud Deum, et Deus erat verbum. Hoc erat in principio apud Deum. Omnipotens factus sunt, et simul factus nihil quo factum est. In ipso vita erat lux homini, lux in tenebris, luce in tenebrae non comprehenderunt. Fuit homo missus ad aequo in nomine Rati Iohannes. Hic veniti testimoni, mu testimoni beberit lumine, et omnes credunt per illum. Non erit in lux, erat testimoni beberit lumine. Erat lux vere, qua lumina ad omnem hominem venientem in hoc mundum. In mundo erat, in mundus principum factus est, in mundus non cognovit. Propri veniti sum non receperunt. Quod alterum ceperunt, eum despot estatum filios Dei fieri quisque credunt in nomine eius, qui non sanguinibus, nec voluntati carnis, nec voluntati viri, sed externati sunt. Et verbum caro factum est, et habitavit in nobis et vinimus gloria meus, gloria in quasi unigenitia Patria, per un grazia in veritatis. Deo gratia.